हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द वीडियो ऑन प्रीवियस ईयर फार्माकोलॉजी क्वेश्चंस। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन सम एमसीक्यू फ्रॉम फार्माकोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट आस्क इन जीपैट 2019। दिस इज माय यूट्यूब चैनल फार्मा कॉम्पिटिटर। इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो कंटेंट देन शेयर द वीडियो विथ यूअर फ्रेंड एंड डू सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। So let's coming to the question number 1. Cardiac output is, the cardiac output is the volume of blood ejected by the left ventricle per minute. If your per beat is written, then it will be stroke volume, not a cardiac output. So the cardiac output is volume of blood ejected by the left ventricle per minute, and the normal cardiac output of the heart is 5 to 6 liter per minute. The cardiac output is multiplication of stroke volume and heart rate. So coming to the question number 2, what are sutures? Sutures are the joints. They joins or binds the bones in the skull with the help of fibrous tissue. So option D is correct for question number 2. The sutures are fibrous joints of the skull. The question number 3 is, following are the facts regarding clinical application of muscarinic receptor blocking drug. The muscarinic receptor blocking drug means anticholinergic drug, and identify the false statement. So option A is, used in the treatment of Parkinson's disease, is often an exercise in polypharmacy since no single agent is fully effective. Yes, it is true, because anticholinergic drug used in the treatment of Parkinson's disease, but no single drug is fully effective. So option A is correct or true. Option C is, mydriasis produce greatly facilitate the ophthalmoscopic examination of retina and measurement of refractive error in uncooperative patient. It is also true, because by contraction of radial muscle of the eye, the anticholinergic drug causes the mydriasis of eye, and it is helpful for ophthalmoscopic examination of the retina. Option D is, scopolamine is one among the old remedy used in treatment of seasickness. It is also true, because scopolamine or hyoscine is used in the treatment of seasickness or motion sickness. So option A, B, A, option A, C and D are true about muscarinic receptor blocking drug, and option B is incorrect. So it is a choice of option for question number 3. Question number 4 is, which of the following cells are called as scavenger cells? The option A is neutrophils, option B is natural killer cells, option C is macrophages, and option D is mast cell. These all four cells are phagocytic cells. Out of four, macrophages are called as scavenger cells. So option C is correct option for question number. Next question is, which is not true about calcitriol? The calcitriol is an active form of vitamin D3, so it is true. Option A is true. The calcitriol main function is, it increases the calcium and phosphate level in the blood. So to increase the calcium and phosphate level, it acts on three organs. First is intestine. It enhances the absorption of calcium and phosphate from the intestine. So ultimately blood level of calcium and phosphate is increases. Second is kidney tubules. It increases or enhance the reabsorption of calcium and phosphate from the renal tubule and prevent the loss of calcium and phosphate through the urination. So option C is it prevent tubular reabsorption of calcium and phosphate. No, it does not prevent, it enhances the tubular reabsorption. So option C is not true about calcitriol. So it is a option of choice for question number 5. And third organ on which calcitriol acts or show their action is the bone. In bone there are two types of cells. First is osteoblast. Osteoblast cell cause the formation of bone. And second is osteoclast cell. Osteoclast cell causes the breakdown of bone. Due to breakdown of bone, the calcium and phosphates are released from the bone into the blood. So calcitriol stimulate the osteoclast cells and cause the breakdown of bone, and then calcium present in bone it is released into the blood, and ultimately blood calcium and phosphate level is increases. So answer of the question 5 is C, because it does not prevent but it enhances the reabsorption of calcium and phosphate. So it is not true about calcitriol. Next question is question number 7. Production of abnormal IgG immunoglobulin in Graves' disease causes. The IgG antibodies acts or binds to the antibody receptor on the thyroid gland, and it enhances the secretion or formation of thyroid hormone T4 and T3. So increased level of T3 and T4 in the blood results into thyrotoxicosis. So correct option for the question number 7 is option C. Next question is, metabolic acidosis does not occurs during. In case of starvation and uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, the acidic ketone bodies, for example beta hydroxybutyrate, is increased in the blood, and due to the increased blood level of acidic ketone bodies, the metabolic acidosis is occur. In case of chronic renal failure, the main function of kidney is to maintain the acid base balance, but if there is a renal failure, then carbonic acid level in the blood is increases and metabolic acidosis is occur. But in case of wound healing, there is a no metabolic acidosis is occur. So it is a correct option for question number
next
8.
Question is, glucocorticoids have following effects except. The option B is resistance to stress.
Yes, glucocorticoid are resistance to the stress. It causes the lipolysis. Yes, in adipose tissue it causes the lipolysis and protein breakdown and glucose formation, that is gluconeogenesis and protein breakdown is
The cause of glucocorticoid. Glucocorticoid increases protein breakdown and glucose formation in liver. So option B, C and D are correct about glucocorticoid, but glucocorticoid does not cause stimulation of immune response. So it decreases or reduces the immune response but does not stimulate the immune response. So option A is correct for question number 9. Identify the drug which is not useful in treatment of tuberculosis. So option A is pyrazinamide. It is used in tuberculosis. Option B is gentamicin. No, it is not used in tuberculosis. It is an antifungal drug. Streptomycin. Streptomycin is also used in the treatment of tuberculosis. And ciprofloxacin, it is also used in treatment of tuberculosis. So here, not useful in tuberculosis is gentamicin. So option B is correct. The question 11 is, what is anaplasia? The anaplasia is a pathological term which means there is a change in morphology and function of the normal cells. So if there is a morphological and functional changes in the cells is occur, so the cells differ from the normal cells and this term is called as anaplasia. Similar to anaplasia, another term is dysplasia. Dysplasia means there is an abnormal arrangement or abnormal development of the cells in tissue. It is called as dysplasia. Next question is, which of the following is directly inhibits the factor 10A? Factor 10 is called as Stort factor, and following option A, dabigatran, and option C, bivalirudin. These both drug inhibit the thrombin. The option B is warfarin. Warfarin inhibit the vitamin K, which is responsible for activation of the blood clotting factor. And option D is rivaroxaban. Rivaroxaban is directly inhibit the factor 10. So the correct option for question number 12 is option D, rivaroxaban. Here H is not, it is a B. Option, question 13 is, which of the following anticonvulsant have both inhibition of excitatory glutaminergic synapse and facilitation of the GABA mediated chloride channel opening action? So here option B is ethosuximide. It is a drug of choice for absent seizure. It acts only on T type of calcium channels in the brain. It inhibits the T type of calcium channels in the brain. So it is used in absent seizure and not a correct option for question number 13. Topiramate. Topiramate acts on sodium channel and it increases or prolongs the inactivation time of sodium channel. So it is also incorrect option for this question. And phenytoin. Phenytoin acts on excitatory glutaminergic synapse but does not act on GABA mediated chloride chloride channel, so it is also incorrect. The option A is valproate. Valproate acts on both, that is GABA mediated chloride channel as well as glutaminergic synapses. So option A is correct option for question number 13. Next is, which of the following is not cardioselective blocker? There are two types of beta blocker. First one is non-selective and second is cardioselective. So option A, bisoprolol, nebivolol and acebutolol are these three are cardioselective, but option D, pindolol, is a non-selective beta blocker, so option D is correct. Question number 15 is, the term aneurysm is refers to. There is a permanent abnormal dilatation of blood vessel is observed, then this term is called as aneurysm. Aneurysm is permanent abnormal dilatation of the blood vessels. Next question is, antiemetic activity of glycopyrronium is related with potent inhibition of the receptor both peripherally and centrally. So glycopyrronium is an anticholinergic drug. It shows the antiemetic activity by binding or by inhibition of the M1 receptor both centrally and peripherally. So option C is correct. The drug like ondansetron and granisetron inhibit the 5-HT3 receptor and show the antiemetic activity, while promethazine is a drug which inhibit the H1 receptor and show the antiemetic activity. So option C is correct for question number 16 because glycopyrronium shows antiemetic activity by inhibition of M1 receptor. Question 17 is, identify the false statement about benzodiazepine from the following. The option A is, benzodiazepine causes the reduction of anxiety. Yes, it is true because it is anxiolytic drug and it reduces the anxiety. Option B is, benzodiazepine causes the convulsion. Convulsions means epilepsy or seizure. The benzodiazepine does not cause the convulsion but used to prevent the convulsion or to treat the convulsion. So it is incorrect or false about benzodiazepine. So question number 17 is false statement about benzodiazepine and option B is correct. The benzodiazepine produces the muscle relaxation and loss of motor coordination. So it is true because it produces the muscle relaxation. For example, diazepam is used as a skeletal muscle relaxant. Option D is, benzodiazepine are useful in insomnia. Yes, benzodiazepine show the sedative and hypnotic action, so it is useful in insomnia. Question number 18 is, which of the following is 5-alpha reductase inhibitor? The option A is glycolazide. Glycolazide is a sulfonyl urea derivative. It is used in diabetes, so it is incorrect. Sildenafil is used in erectile dysfunctioning and it is a phosphoesterase, phosphodiesterase 5 inhibitor, so it is also incorrect. Polythiazide is diuretic, so it does not inhibit the 5 alpha reductase inhibitor. The option C is correct. Finasteride is 5 alpha reductase inhibitor, so correct option is C. Question number 19 is, several different chemicals released by the microbes and inflamed tissue attract the phagocytes. This phenomenon is called as, when the chemicals released by the microbes and inflamed tissue attracts the phagocytes, then it is called as chemotaxis. Option C is correct. Next question is, hematocrit 65-70% indicates. Now what is hematocrit? Hematocrit is the percentage of RBCs in blood. It is the percentage of RBCs in the blood. So when the hematocrit is 65-70%, it indicates the polycythemia, which means excess of RBCs in the blood. When the hematocrit is low, then it is indication of anemia. Question number 21 is, the adverse reaction associated with alpha agonist administered by inhalation or nebulization in the management of asthma does not include. Here, hypertension is correct option, because hypertension is not occur by administration of alpha 2 agonist in asthma patients. Question 22 is, select the ulcer protective drug from the following. Ulcer protective drug, here oxyphenonium is anticholinergic drug. It reduce the secretion of the acid. Metronidazole is anti-anthelmintic drug, so it act against H. pylori. Misoprostol is also inhibit the secretion of the gastric acid, and it is prostaglandin analog. Option D is sucralfate. It is ulcer protective drug. So option D is correct. Question number 23 is, disturbances of estrogen progesterone balance could cause relative deficiency of DASH, leading to disturbances in the production of dopamine and serotonin. This contributes for emotional disturbances and depression. When there is a deficiency of estrogen or progesterone, or the imbalance between estrogen and progesterone, then it also leads to the relative deficiency of pyridoxine phosphate. And when the pyridoxine phosphate deficiency is occur, then it also disturbs the production of dopamine and serotonin. So due to decreased production of dopamine and serotonin, it leads to the depression and emotional behavior is observed in such patient. So option C is correct for question number 23. Next question is, testing of chemicals by OECD guideline number 420 refers to which of the following. The OECD guideline number 420 is related with acute oral toxicity by fixed dose procedure. So option D is correct. Last question is, which of the following is true about excessive use of diuretics? Diuretics, as the word indicate, it increase the urination. When diuretic is taken, it decrease the extracellular volume, extracellular fluid volume, and increase the urination. If we take diuretic in excess, then the extracellular fluid volume is a decrease, and due to decreased volume, hypovolemic shock is occur when we use the diuretic in excess amount. So thank you.